So we got this story that's been going viral, and considering we're talking about police brutality, let's jump into it. Daily Mail says, moment, five white Maryland police officers tase and arrest black teenager after he ignored warning to stop vaping on the sidewalk, on the boardwalk. So I don't know if you guys saw this. The video is actually really straightforward. It's just like this kid. He's walking down the boardwalk. They tell him to stop vaping. Stop. He puts his hands up. And then when he goes to take his backpack off, they just tase him. And he goes down and they jump on him. People are freaking out. It's not the most egregious video in terms of police brutality or Black Lives Matter. But I'm interested to get your guys' thoughts on this as a more, you know, libertarian view of these things. I'll say right now, two things. They shouldn't have done it, obviously. The dude went and reached to put his backpack off, but you see his hand go behind his back.
There it is.
Cop probably thought he was going for something.
Yeah. Or he's not going to risk whether or not he was. He thought it was possible.
And it was a taser. He wasn't killing him.
Yeah. Honestly, of all the things I've seen, it's probably one of the least egregious, even though I hate it. And I think it's absurd that you would be enforcing a law like that. I can't get all in an uproar over this one in particular, just because, yes, he did reach. Like, I can understand from the cop's perspective, especially since he's not using lethal force. I can understand that one. The one that really bothered me was that cop, I don't remember what state it was in, but for speeding and he flipped the woman over.
A pregnant woman.
He pits a pregnant woman at like 55 miles per hour. That one infuriated
when me. When she's trying to pull over safely at an exit.
Unbelievable.
Because there was dividers.
With their hazards on.
Yeah, I mean, yesterday driving here, I had a truck hit my RV. And my RV was swerving everywhere. I'm like, there's no way I'm pulling on the side here. I had to wait 2 miles. And then luckily a good Samaritan told me, you know, what happened and was a witness. But again, like, stopping on the highway is extremely dangerous. A lot of people die doing this. This woman was trying to do the right thing. She put her hazards on, slowed down, and was showing that she was going to pull over a pregnant woman. And this police officer, without any care, without any consideration, just does this maneuver, flips her car over, and
no
then
charges.
No charges. And the most damning part, when he gets out of his vehicle after she's upside down, he walks towards her without even pulling his weapon. He is not at all afraid for his life. Why are you using lethal force if you're not afraid for your life?
And then he
I get an answer there?
And then he talks her down. He's like, why didn't you stop? She's like, I was trying. She's like, you should have done it earlier. And I'm like, are you kidding me?
Unbelievable.
The level of disrespect, I mean, there's so many stupid laws out there. If someone wants to douche loot, let him douche loot. But these interactions are unnecessary. If someone's literally outside douche looting with their vape, let him do it. I don't care. It doesn't bother me.
Are you saying abolish the police?
I'm saying.
So you're saying
privatize.
Get rid of all cops.
That's what you're saying. Yeah.
Listen.
So you're saying you want to abolish all the police.
I'm not a fan of using force and having the monopoly of violence to enforce the absolute stupidest laws, especially when it comes to lockdowns, especially when it comes to restrictions. A lot of people, even on the right, even Trump supporters, are waking up. Even Ezra Levant, of all people, he's coming out and he's like full almost. He's full almost ACAB, almost there. And he's going crazy.
He's the rebel guy in Canada. He's like
And he used to love police officers. He used to be like, he used to be the biggest back the blue guy.
Hey.
And then people have to acknowledge there's a big contradiction between the back the blue and the people who believe in the Constitution. There's a big contradiction there that people need to wake up to.
Right.
Didn't Paul Joseph Watson used to make videos like against police brutality, like back in the day?
Alex Jones and InfoWars, Prison Planet 1, 2, and 3. And then they came out with, you know, being full Trump supporters and backing the blue.
What was that
all
about?
Which is a big flip, which they deserve some criticism on, but they get picked on enough, to be honest, and they don't deserve, you know, a lot of the criticism that they get, but they do deserve that criticism.
If you have the whole deep state against you, you can't also have the cops against you. You gotta pick one of the other.
Like, is the difference between back the blue and back the monarchy? Am I off base
Canadians?
Saying that? Yeah, like, you don't have to back the monarchy to back the blue, and you don't have to hate the police to hate the monarchy.
No, I think in Canada, it's their red. They're Mounties, right? They wear red.
I don't know. Didn't the queen
decide they ride the red.
And they ride moose, right?
Definitely.
They ride horses.
They ride moose.
If you really want to be...
No, they don't ride moose. You're going to get fact-checked, Tim.
It's a joke.
Let me stop you
but
right
they
there.
Would if they could. Moose. Fact-check. Fact-check me on that.
What's the plural of moose? Meese?
Mooses?
Dude, it's mooses, obviously.
Mooses. just moose.
If you really want to be infuriated, you start watching the police videos and encounters that are happening in Canada. People showing up to people's homes because they have a foreign car in their driveway. People showing up to businesses, shutting them down. People going to churches, arresting pastors that are practicing their religion. What's happening in Canada, I believe, was designed to happen in the United States. And it only didn't happen because of a few states that stood up for their rights, Florida being one of them, Texas that followed suit, but truly Florida, and this is an understatement, and it's not just because I'm wearing the t-shirt that I have, that I sell myself, but Florida truly, I believe the bigger statement here that they made is far more significant than we give credence to, because what they did is essentially prove how lockdowns are pointless. Well, you know, people are saying people are going to be dropping dead all over in Florida. There's going to be mass graves in Florida. The whole population is going to die in Florida. None of that happened. And it proved that the lockdowns were a lie from the very beginning.
A well-regulated militia being necessary to the security of a free state, the right of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed. I'll explain this to a lot of people. So to all my liberal friends who are pro-gun control, who don't understand because they like to come out with these Facebook comments where they're like, what do you think you're going to do? Go to war with the government? You're so dumb. The first thing I'll say is Vietnam and Afghanistan. Mm-hmm. Yes, simple arms are effective against a tyrannical government or just an oppressive force regardless. But no, I don't think anyone's going to go to war against the government. I hope they don't. I just think that when the police officers go knocking on Breonna Taylor's house and they kick the door in, and then Breonna Taylor's boyfriend hears someone breaking in and fires in defense, the charges against him get dropped. That's literally what happened. Why? Because you have a right to keep and bear arms, and should you believe that you are you're intruded upon, you have a right to defend yourself. So those charges got dropped. In the United States, when the police want to serve a warrant, they have to contend with the fact that they may be entering the home of someone who is armed. They have to be very careful about how they do it, make sure they have the proper warrants and the legal authority to go up against someone who may be armed. In Canada, where they don't, they kick the door in, beat the wife, and drag the guy out of the house.
Yep.
And it's not about going to war. It's about just having a more even playing field where the police are obligated to respect the process.
It's a deterrent.
And respect the individual, respect the human being. In Canada, they banned a large portion of firearms right before the whole COVID-19 lockdown. That also needs to be acknowledged. Australia also got rid of people's ability to defend themselves and to have firearms. Also, wait, some of the most strictest lockdowns in the entire world, Australia, Canada, and now they're trying to do it here in the United States.
You're telling me that they banned weapons before they tried to implement tyranny? Hmm. There's yes, historical precedent for that.
It's crazy that it's the British Commonwealth that's where this is happening. It's terrifying.
And that's why at least one former element of the British Commonwealth was like, we should have guns. And then the crown was like, nah, you got to give up your guns. And they were like, no. Dude, and they were like, then we're going to go, you know, attack you. And then they fought back.
It is embarrassing to watch Biden interact with like G7 and stuff. But man, watching the queen is like just delusional. She's like hobbling, humped over, can barely move. Like, this is the leader of Britain. This is it.
Well, the empire certainly has come a long way, to put it mildly.
Well, she's a representative figure that, you know, always has. I can't even say the words here. She has people like Jimmy Savile, Edward Heath, Jeffrey Epstein, always around her family members.
Prince Andrew?
Yeah, that's their relatives.
Is she any more empty figurehead than Biden at this point, honestly?
The royal family being connected to individuals who do unspeakable things to children is far too extensive not to mention here. And it's absolutely, truly disgusting to see
how weird is that?
Three-fourths of the things I want to say, I can't say on this
show.
They're
so powerful. It's one of the largest land-owning families on Earth, I think, is the Queen's family.
Oh, like
the Catholic Church?
Yeah, they own a ton of land all over the place, right?
Yeah, I think so. I'd have to look
it up. Isn't like the largest landowner in Manhattan Trinity Church? Something like that?
I don't know.
Or one of the largest?
I thought it was CCP.
China in New York?
I don't know.
I wouldn't be surprised, to be completely honest.
Yeah,
Been a huge influx of Chinese capital into American real estate.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, didn't Texas, like someone's trying to, in Texas, ban the purchasing of land by Chinese nationals or something like that? Or the Chinese Communist Party?
I believe it, yeah.
Isn't it kind of weird that we allow that in the first place? I was talking to an accountant, and they were saying something about like foreign nationals can start a business in the United States. You don't need to be a citizen. Then they'll use that business to grant themselves citizenship. They'll use the business, say, oh, I work for this company and I need to come to the United States, and they'll use that. That seems kind of crazy to me that here's how the world works. If you're rich, you can do whatever you want. Seriously.
In Mexico, I still can't buy real estate, though. So there are I can't. It has to be held in some sort of like trust or LLC or something like that.
I think Brazil might be similar.
Yeah, many countries have that because the Americans, with all their wealth, were coming in and buying up all the prime real estate.
So why don't we do that?
Well, I think that, I mean, we just first off, we have more capital than most foreigners, or at least we did historically, so we didn't have to worry about someone from Brazil coming in and outbidding an American because they didn't have the kind of income they did. The playing field is being leveled, where there are, you know, many, many billionaires across the globe.
Thanks for checking out this clip from the TimCast IRL podcast. If you want to see the full show, come back to this channel, youtube.com/TimCastIRL, Monday through Friday at 8 p.m., where you can leave comments and super chat, and we actually will read your comments on the show. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe. And if you want exclusive members-only content, segments you can't get anywhere else, go to timcast.com, become a member, and we even have full bonus episodes. Thanks for hanging out, and we'll see you all next time.